Ladies and gentlemen, this is just a reminder, the Dunn-Oliver Ecodome as well as the Alabama State University campus is mask mandatory. Masks must be worn at all times while inside the venue. Thank you so much for your cooperation. Also keep in mind to remain socially distant throughout the evening. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, season tickets for the 2021-2022 basketball season are currently on sale. They can be purchased by calling 334-229-4551 or by visiting alabamastatesports.com. Thank you. once again, ladies and gentlemen, for more information on Alabama State University Athletics, be sure to follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. Search Bama State Sports for all your up-to-the-minute information supporting athletics. Also visit BamaStateSports.com, the official athletics website of the Alabama State University.
Hey, 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 hey.
again, ladies and gentlemen, you can keep up with the Alabama State Athletics on the Hornet Sports Network with games carried on YouTube as well as BamaStateSports.com throughout the season.
Ain't this what they've been waiting for? You ready? I used to pray for times like this, to rhyme like this, so I had to grind like that, to shine like this. In a matter of time, I spent on some locked up shit in the back of the paddy wagon, cuts locked on wrist. See my dreams unfold, nightmares come true. It was time to marry the game, and I said, yeah, I do. If you want it, you gotta see it with a clear eye view. Got shorties, you try to bless me like I said, I do. Like a nip, sneeze, nip, please, for the trip, squeeze them, get crazy. Never let them hope get in between them. What we started, love, but I'm lying. How did they let me when I was stuck in their head? When that departed, I go and get it. Got it, draw it like I'm an artist. We're crawling, restricted, walking with foreigners. And my garage is a foreign bitch. But now you fuck sucking and swallowing anything for a dollar. They tell me get him, I got him. I did it without an album. This shit, Mariah. Love me, I'm on fire.
Good afternoon and good evening, I should say. Welcome, everybody. You're tuned into the Hornet Sports Network. My name is Aquan Lee, and you're joined with me by Daryl Dapridge. It's the second game of our doubleheader here at the Dunn Oliver Acadome. It's your Alabama State Hornets versus the Braves of Alcorn State. This is the second game of our three-game homestand here at home. After this one, we'll host Alabama A&M. Then it's back on the road for Alabama State. For now, the Hornets will try to make it two games in a row, coming off a good statement win against Jackson State their last time out on Saturday. And it was a pretty good Saturday win. Everybody did their job, and there were no miscues on offense that could really leave head coach Mo Williams saying, hey, we could have done this a lot better. It was just an all-about team effort.
It really was, and the interesting thing about this matchup is that both Alcorn State and Alabama State have a common opponent, and that's Jackson State. Alcorn State went to Jackson, Mississippi, and opened up SWAC play with a 15-point victory over the Tigers, then went to Huntsville and beat Alabama A&M by 6. So they start off 2-0 in the SWAC. This is a team that has played on the West Coast, teams like Gonzaga, Portland, Seattle. They played Baylor. They played Oklahoma. They played a really, really tough schedule, as has Alabama State. So they are a very formidable opponent tonight for Alabama State, and they're led by Dominic Bruton and Linnell Henry. Henry starts. Bruton comes off the bench. Alcorn State looking to go 3-0 in the SWAC against Mo Williams Hornets.
We mentioned Saturday's game. It was a big win for Alabama State, 72-57. That score, again, an all-around team effort. Their leading scorer was Kenny Strawbridge, and he's been one of the big names for Alabama State, both on offense and on defense. He can do a little bit of everything, and he's one of the big three, the three players for Alabama State that average double figures in points.
Yeah, they go really, really deep. They've got balanced scoring. I really like the way DJ Jackson has been playing lately, running the point. They've kind of gone with that two-headed monster. E.J. Clark and D.J. Jackson can both handle the basketball. They can both run the point if they have to, so that helps when they break the press. And then Gerald Liddell and Jordan O'Neill and Kenny Strawbridge have been money down low. The bench has really come off and participated and has done a great job as well. Isaiah Range has gotten the start the last couple games. He'll be coming off the bench tonight, but he's been providing an offensive spark as well, DeQuan.
Absolutely. You mentioned Gerald Liddell. He's this team's leading scorer, coming in averaging 11 points per game. Kenny Strawbridge averages 10 himself, as does Trace Young. He got a DNP last time out. Let's see if he comes off the bench this afternoon and gives head coach Mo Williams some time and some good effort. It'll be interesting to see as we're approaching a minute here before tip-off.
Trace Young's really the enigma of this basketball team. I have yet to see him play. This is my sixth broadcast, and it just so happens that I have not had the opportunity. He's been DNPing when I've played. At some point during the year, he was Alabama State's leading scorer. You need his size. You need his scoring ability. You're going to need him as far as the depth situation for this Hornet basketball team.
Only 8 games played for Trace Young. And it's going to be a question how much longer until we see him perform in these SWAC conference games. Eventually, the Hornets are going to need him in a big way. And, of course, he averages double figures. You need those points in any facet.
6'8", he plays a little bit longer with the wingspan. He's a big key component of this Alabama State roster.
The question this afternoon is where are the points going to come from Alabama State? Of course, you'll take over 3-pointers when you get that opportunity, but they average paltry 30% as a team, 31% rounded up. And if you can't hit from outside, that's only going to clog up your inside and make it harder for anybody to get inside that lane and penetrate.
Yeah, Alcorn State's going to be a tough matchup. They got some size. They have a lot of athleticism. They start a front line of 6'7 and 6'7, two 6'7 guys, and a 6'8. So 6'7, 6'7, 6'8 for Alcorn State, and that's a formidable tall front line.
As we get ready to introduce the starting lineups for both teams, you mentioned the height discrepancy in between the two teams. The starters for Alcorn State, of course, you mentioned Linnell Henry. He'll be in the starting lineup along with Byron Joshua, Justin Thomas, Keandre Montgomery, and Samanza Hart. Those are the starters for your Alcorn State Braves. And then for Alabama State, you've got D.J. Jackson, Jordan O'Neill, Gerald Liddell, E.J. Clark, and Kenny Strawbridge, as we mentioned. Those make up the starting five for your Alabama State Hornets. So a typical lineup for Alabama State, although E.J. Clark expected to get some good run as that two guard for Mo Williams.
Yeah, he kind of took the place of Juan Reyna, who was running the point for Alabama State early on in the year, getting the start, and they were bringing D.J. Jackson off the bench. They no longer do that. They bring Juan Reyna off the bench. He's a very good three-point shooter. Look to see if he could get some instant offense coming off the bench.
The freshman from San Antonio had a good little stint to start the year, but I guess the freshman inexperience caught up with him to a certain point, and the upperclassmen started to get a little bit more burned.
They really are, and it's a great experience, but what it does is it provides depth. There's a long SWAC season that basically lies ahead for this Alabama State basketball team. You're going to need to go 9 or 10 deep. Alabama State hoping to do that. Guys coming off the bench and playing good minutes. Guys like Jamie Mitchell and Michael Barber have also contributed off the bench. So, I mean, it's going to be interesting to see how many Coach Mo Williams plays tonight, looking for maybe 11 or 12 guys to contribute.
On the defensive end for Alabama State, a big enforcer, we should say, for the Hornets is Jordan O'Neill. He's a big menacing man down low in the paint. He protects the rim with such ferocity, never afraid to chase a shot and send it out of bounds. He does it quite often for Alabama State.
I also want to see what Alabama State does to counter the size advantage down low. Will they double down? Will they bring help from the guards? Will they just let their forwards play one-on-one with the Alcorn State forwards?
As you can hear, they're finishing up the introductions for our starting five. Set to tip it off here in just a second.
Alcorn State comes out in the purple uniforms trimmed in gold. Alabama State will wear the traditional home whites trimmed with black and gold. Henry will jump it for the Braves.
6'8 graduate out of Chicago, Illinois, listed at 215. Alabama State finishing up their final huddle of the afternoon. Jordan O'Neill to tip things off for Alabama State. Jordan O'Neill ,6'7" forward out of Mobile, Alabama. Alcorn State wins the tip, and they'll start with the first possession of the ball game. Justin Thomas defended by DJ Jackson. They go down line one side to Linnell. They bring the double team immediately. Good ball movement by the Braves. They get Liddell in the air. Good ball movement once again. Shot clock ticking. 10 for the Braves. Thought about the free throw line jumper instead. They'll go with the baseline jumper. And the connection leads to an easy two-pointer by Linnell Henry.
Yeah, a little mid-range baseline jumper that time by Linnell Henry.
A good offensive set on the first strike by Alcorn State. Let's see what Alabama State can respond with.
Interesting. Clark running the point. DJ moving to the wing. They both can handle the one position.
Liddell will try a three-pointer. Off the back iron. One and done for the offense of Alabama State. Keandre Montgomery with the board. 6'7 freshman out of Jackson, Mississippi. The double team comes. Long outlet pass. Good ball movement once again. Braves are on top of the double team. Hornets starting with a little man-to-man. Liddell with the block. Shot rejected out of bounds. Montgomery had the attempt. First one no good. Braves will get it back with 9 seconds on the shot clock.
It's a big block, too, because Montgomery had a step.
Linnell takes it back out. Three-pointer again. Rims out. Jordan O'Neill with the rebound. Alabama State pushing the tempo. DJ Jackson thought about the three-pointer. Kenny Strawbridge trails behind. Puts it on the floor. Gets inside and finishes with the left hand.
It's a nice job by Kenny Strawbridge. And he switches hands as he elevates to the rim.
Kenny Strawbridge scores the first points for Alabama State. Justin Thomas kicks back out, and they start back at the top of the key. Montgomery off the screen. He's got O'Neill on him. He'll kick it back out. Thomas will work with 8 on the shot clock. Screen coming from Henry. Good acceleration into the paint. Jump ball called. It'll be Alabama State basketball.
Good job by DJ Jackson getting his hand in there. He didn't really rip at the ball. He just kind of reached in and held it stationary. And that's why, because he didn't slap Daquan, he didn't get called for the foul. He gets the tie up.
2 minutes passed here in the first quarter. 2-2, all nutted up. DJ Jackson, he'll set up again for the three-pointer. Corner three, way short, one and done. Samanza Hart with the rebound. Inside to Henry. Henry, good post position, and the reverse layup falls.
Henry right now has got all the points for Alcorn State. That was a nice little up and under move. Very tough to defend that because one side of the rim shields you off.
Jordan O'Neill getting into the paint. The dish to the wrong color jersey. Turnover for Alabama State, going the other way. The floater inside, rims out. And Kenny Strawbridge corrals the miss. Liddell, the floater inside the paint, doesn't get the bounce. One and done once again for Alabama State. A little bit of fast tempo here for both teams. Byron Joshua will set the play out. First substitution getting ready to check in for Alcorn State. Dontrell McWhorter awaits the first dead ball. Eight on the shot clock. The double team comes. Alabama State concedes the three-pointer, and they make a pay. Keontre Montgomery splashes in the first triple of the evening.
Wide open on the perimeter. Montgomery 6'7", but he looked pretty pure on that shot.
Alabama State trying to make it two games in a row here at home. The second of a three-game homestand. Kick out. E.J. Clark. He answers back with a triple of his own.
It's a good answer. It's nice rotation as E.J. Clark gets to the wing and drains the three.
Off-ball screen. Henry trying to get free, trying to post up. They abandon the play. Montgomery. Thought he picked up his dribble for a second. Keeps it alive, penetrating. Oh, good denial inside by D.J. Jackson. Sends it away, and the Hornets come out on the break. Liddell, the crossover, inside, the dish. Strawbridge couldn't handle it, but it was deflected out of bounds by the Braves. It'll maintain as Hornets basketball. We'll take a media timeout. When we return, we'll have our action in the first half of Hornet basketball. The score, 7-5 in favor of your Alabama State Hornets. Stay tuned. It's the Hornets Sports Network.
Hornet Nation, you can make an immediate impact on the Alabama State University Department of Intercollegiate Athletics by joining the Hornet Club. Your membership will continue to help grow the best student athletes in the country. The Hornet Club is the official fundraising arm for the Department of Athletics, so come join us and continue to elevate, execute, and enhance the opportunities for our student athletes for years to come. Invest in the next. Visit GammaStateSports.com for more information.
Following the media timeout,
into the game after the timeout,
it'll be Alabama State basketball.
11, Jamie Mitchell.
Jamie Mitchell on the floor for the first time for head coach Mo Williams. Williams in his second year at the helm for Alabama State. Looking to get Alabama State back on track in the SWAC. With two new additions in Bethune-Cookman and Florida A&M. It'll be interesting to see how this season shapes up. 10 on the shot clock for Alabama State. Good pick and roll play. Jordan O'Neal, that's going to be, a traveling violation.
He had the shot, too. If he just would have turned around, he had a 10-footer. A
little indecisive with his decision-making there.
Had the 10-footer. There was nobody. As he cleared the pass, he turned around expecting somebody to be up on him, and there wasn't anybody.
Thomas penetrating. They get the switch with Strawbridge on him. Size mismatch inside. Turnaround jumper denied by Mitchell. Jordan O'Neal clears the miss. Hornets come back the other way. Jackson, the crossover, getting inside the paint. Dishes it off to O'Neal. Loses the handle. Gets it to Mitchell. Mitchell, no good on the layup. O'Neal. Henry swipes it away. Braves come back. Launch the corner three. Too strong. Mitchell flies in for the rebound. A lot of back and forth action here. DJ Clark, strong on the drive. The floater off glass. It will not count. Offensive foul on E.J. Clark. He can't believe it.
Man, he's been such an offensive spark plug. That would have been 5 points for him right out of the gate. And they call the offensive foul.
Michael Barber set to check in now for the first time this evening. Montgomery for the Braves will also take a seat, catch his first breather. In his place comes Otis Walker. Good move. Kick out to the corner. Three-pointer on the way and swirls in. That's the second swirl shot we've seen this evening. Linnell Henry, good for three.
Linnell Henry with 7 of the 10 Alcorn State points right now. Alabama State's got to find an answer for him.
Barber penetrating, getting inside, had it stripped. Another turnover for Alabama State. Byron Joshua leaked ahead, but instead, oh, good swipe and a good force of the turnover. Michael Barber, after creating a turnover, he forces one on the Braves. That's a good way to respond, get back in the game.
Knocked it right off his foot. A little tricky maneuver there. Juan Reyna in the ballgame now. See if, you know, Alcorn State's leaving three-point shooters open for Alabama State, just haven't been able to knock them down. 1 of 3 right now. See if they leave it open for Reyna or if they got the scouting report that he's deadly from out there. Right now he's wide open. Well, they bring Linnell out on him. Here we go.
Good ball movement straight to the corner. Juan Reyna, too strong on the three-pointer.
He's got to knock that down. That's a wide open three. That's what he's in the game for, and that's a big three.
Good opportunity for him, just a little too strong. Maybe a bit gun-shy. First attempt came in as soon as he came in the game, but you got to stay ready. 5-point advantage for Alcorn State. Coming up on 13 and a half minutes remaining in the first half. Linnell Henry has been strong for the Braves. Good double team comes. Ball movement. Top of the three key is drilled. Braves are hitting from outside at a huge clip right now. Walker for three.
Otis Walker, and it's 13 to 5.
Joshua all up on DJ Jackson. The spin move to free himself. The Euro can't finish. Second chance. Back in the hands of Juan Reyna, but he can't maintain control. It'll change the hands and go to the Braves.
Shooting right now, that's the key. 2 of 8 for Alabama State, only 25%. 5 of 10 and 3 of 5 behind the arc for Alcorn State.
It's the three-point shooting that's hurting Alabama State. You're right. They double team often, and it's leading to the open shooter, and they're cashing in on their opportunities. 15 on the shot clock for Alcorn State. Driving baseline, another corner three-pointer. This time too strong, offensive rebound now. McWhorter comes down with it, and they'll reset. Thomas swings it. Joshua looking for the play call with 10. Gets the screen. Good post position inside for McWhorter. He kicks it out. Three on the shot clock. The step back three-pointer on the way. Walker drills it. The hot hand continues. 2 of 3 from deep for Walker.
And the shot clock was about to run out. Those are doubly disappointing.
They call it a two-pointer on the floor, so it remains a 10-point ball game and a 10-point deficit for Alabama State. Foul called on the floor.
Foul on the shot.
They're calling a shot.
The Braves, number 11.
It'll go on Otis Walker. Media timeout on the floor. We'll take a short break. 11:59 remaining in the first half. Alabama State only 5 points on the board and facing a 10-point deficit. It's the Hornet Sports Network.
possession Hornets.
Welcome back, folks. We're just past the 12-minute mark of the first half. Alabama State struggling on offense, trying to get something going. 10-point deficit for them, and they're looking for answers. The Braves have been hot from downtown. Liddell putting on the floor, getting to the rim. Has it denied inside. Henry sends it out of bounds. Hornets will get it back with 13 remaining on the shot clock.
Henry has been all over the place right now for Alcorn State. 6'8 graduate, like we said, from Chicago, Illinois. 7 points, a rebound, now a block.
Leads all scorers in that department. Has more points than Alabama State themselves. Jackson in the corner, driving baseline. Called for a travel. Turnover Hornets. The fifth turnover for Alabama State. They've been scoreless over the past 4.5 minutes, and Alcorn State is on an 8-0 run, a 13-3 run overall. They're running a floppy. They try to spring Walker open. He's already knocked down 2 3-pointers. Walker with Liddell on him. Fades away. Shot won't count. Last touch by the Braves. That'll be Alabama State basketball.
Possession Hornets. Into the game for the Braves, number 44. Into the game for the Hornets, number 23, Ashton McClellan. Also into the game for the Hornets, number 4, E.J. Clark.
Bunch of substitutions coming in for Alabama State. Ashton McClellan checking in for the first time this afternoon. E.J. Clark is back on the floor, as is Juan Reyna. Hornets looking for answers on offense. It's been a very dry spell for him. 2 of 9 from the field, 1 of 4 from deep. Ball deflected out of bounds. Hornets are getting another crack at it with 20 on the shot clock. Juan Reyna to inbound. Liddell, aggressive, pull up. Left it short, rebound by McQuarter. Alcorn State pushing the tempo. McQuarter on the outside. They'll reset with 20 on the shot clock. Paul King on the floor for the first time for Alcorn State.
On the floor,
foul call.
It's
going to be on McClellan.
Substitution is in the game for
his
the
first.
Number 20, Kenny Strawberry.
Juan Reyna having a seat in exchange for Kenny Strawbridge. 3-pointer on the way. No good. Strawbridge with the rebound. He'll keep it himself, as he saw the dive coming from Keandre Montgomery.
Alcorn State will keep firing up now. 3 of 7 from behind the 3-point line.
Their defense has been stout. Hornets haven't gotten many opportunities.
Yeah, Alcorn's really, really aggressive defensively.
Great rotation by him. Liddell tied up. He's going to go for it again. Shot isn't falling for him. He's had some looks, just cannot convert.
The Braves defense, man, they just hound you. Every time you get the ball, they are just on you, double-teaming you, trapping you in corners.
Braves. Last touch
out of bounds on the play
by the Braves. Turnover, Alcorn State. Alabama State catching a break. Well, what can they do with that break? The defense has been everywhere, and they can't seem to get a good shot off.
6 minutes, 17 seconds the last time Alabama State scored a basket.
E.J. Clark getting straight to the basket. Still can't end the scoring drought. Agnew with the rebound. I didn't see his name on the list on the roster. Pull-up jumper by King is good. They're hitting on all cylinders right now. Paul King switches it in for his first attempt and his first make.
Shooting 47% from the field. And they're really playing strong defense.
17-5 to score. Hornets can't get out of the mud offensively. The hold on Jordan O'Neal. That one will go on Agnew.
On the floor, foul charge.
7 minutes and 10 seconds and counting. Alabama State needs a basket in a bad, bad way, as they're only shooting 17% right now.
So number 44, I had on my roster as number four. That's Darius Agnew. Strawbridge backing his way down, spinning, facing the double team, looking to get rid of it. Finds E.J. Clark. Eight on the shot clock. McClellan. Get it back to Clark. The screen by O'Neal. The jumper. No good. Ball remain Alabama State's. Loose ball foul on the floor. That one will go on Otis Walker.
Good job by Liddell. He goes straight up, and he was just trying to go up for a man's rebound. Would not be denied, and Alcorn State had to foul.
Juan Reyna springing open off the inbound. Drills a three, a much-needed one for Alabama State.
That's big, and he needs more of that. That's a big, big stop right there, momentum. He can shoot it.
His first three-pointer of the evening, his second attempt. The answer, King, no good on the attempt. Juan Reyna with the rebound. He'll come the other way, advance it to Strawbridge. Reyna probing. And throws the ball in the traffic, turnover. Try to do a little too much with the basketball. Paul King gives it to the corner to Montgomery. They give it back to King. King with the screen. He'll go inside. Agnew posting up. Good move. Got O'Neal in the air. And he draws the foul. He'll be at the line to shoot two.
Got to take advantage with Linnell Henry out of the lineup and try to cut into this lead, as I think there's immediate timeout. They just called a foul on the shot for Alabama State.
There is immediate timeout, so we'll take one with them. Just past the 8-minute mark in this ball game. Rough stretch for Alabama State. 10-point disadvantage for them. We'll be right back after this. At the line to shoot two following the foul on E.J. Clark. Darius Agnew. Good on the first attempt.
One shot.
Agnew had 4 points in that win against Alabama A&M. Two for two at the stripe.
Braves convert both free throws.
The five on the floor for Alabama State. D.J. Jackson, Kenny Strawbridge, Gerald Liddell, Juan Reyna, and Jordan O'Neal. Jackson getting hounded by King. Strawbridge probing. Layup too strong, and Agnew with the rebound.
It seemed like Alabama State's just throwing shots up. That wasn't even really a controlled layup. He just tossed it up, hoping. But give Alcorn State credit. They are really, really guarding.
11-point advantage. Paul on the penetration. Good kick out. The three-pointer by Montgomery off the back iron. Alabama State advancing the tempo. The Euro. Count the back. Oh, no. Can't get it to fall. Instead, Liddell will be at the line to shoot two.
Yeah, kind of swiped him across the face there.
Two shots.
Would have been a big opportunity for him.
Number three, Gerald Liddell.
Keandre Montgomery went off for 27 points in that win against Alabama A&M. Knocked down 5 3-pointers in that one. It was 9 of 12. Liddell at the line to shoot two. These are his first free throws of the evening. He's the team's leading scorer, averaging 11 points a game.
Got to get Liddell and O'Neal going if Alabama State has a chance to get back in the basketball game.
It seems like Alcorn State is just living in that zone and taking away anything that they can get in the paint, forcing Alabama State to beat them from the exterior, from outside. Three-pointer is not Alabama State's strong suit. Second free throw, no good.
Hornets lose the pair of free throws.
Just past the 7-minute mark of the first half. It's been all Alcorn State in this one. Paul King lost the handle, but that pass too high, deflected off the tip of Agnew's hands, and Jordan O'Neal comes away with that one.
There he is, wide open. Nice pass by DJ.
Three-pointer no good. Fight for the loose ball. Ends up in the hands of Agnew once again. Paul King getting some good minutes. 6-foot senior out of Monroe, Louisiana. He's probing. Good find and pretty reverse. Keandre Montgomery.
He was looking baseline, waiting for Montgomery to clear. He did. It was an easy little reverse layup.
Jamie Mitchell getting set to check in for Alabama State. Good ball moved by Alabama State. Pretty spin move. Jackson finding O'Neal. O'Neal has a shot denied inside on the fast break. Joshua kicks it out. All the time in the world for Montgomery. Can't make him pay. Good closeout nonetheless, and the Hornets come away with it. Strawbridge has a size mismatch. Probably go around his man. A lot of dribbling here. Jackson, he'll try a three-pointer. Left it short. Ball tipped up. Strawbridge corrals it. They'll get a second chance. Juan Reyna will calm it down. 14 on the shot clock for Alabama State. 9-21 your score. Dequan Lee joined by Daryl Dapperidge here. It's been a tough first half for Alabama State. They can't get anything going on offense. Three-pointer on the way by Juan Reyna. Swishes that one in.
That's his spot. He needs to shoot on that side of the court down here. He's missed both. He's made both on this side. Find that spot and rotate over.
5 minutes remaining in the first half. Alabama State, 9-point deficit.
When he makes threes, though, Dupont, it doesn't touch anything.
Hornets in his own. King, pump fake. Three-pointer, no good. Jackson with the rebound. Jackson putting it on. Strawbridge, bodied up, behind the back. Almost lost the handle, loses it. Jackson's there to save it. Good ball movement. Juan Reyna again. Three-pointer.
That's where he needs to set up. That's the money shot right there. That's exactly what he needs to do. That's his spot. Something's going on at half court.
Timeout on the field. No. Some players got into it. I want to see what it was.
I know the basket counts. I hope the basket counts.
Mo Williams pleading with the official with something. We'll take a timeout, folks. We'll be right back. It's the Hornet Sports Network.
technical foul charge to Alabama State number 5, Juan Reyna.
Welcome back, folks. So Juan Reyna has been assessed a technical foul following his free throw that he, excuse me, his three-pointer that
first
he made.
Is good. One shot.
Reduced to lead. It reduced the lead to a six-point advantage. Now back up to an eight-point advantage.
That's big. I mean, you hit a big three like that, and you give two of it right back.
Possession break.
And so that's you got to be smarter than that. Got to be a little more disciplined. Hit a big three, crowds in it. You got to cut to six.
Prior to those free throws, it had been a 6-0 run in favor of Alabama State. Got him back into the game, but it looked like the offense had stalled dead in the water. Jamie Mitchell back on the floor with DJ Jackson, Kenny Strawbridge, Juan Reyna, and Michael Barber. Hornets still playing the double team game. 15 on the shot clock, coming up on 4 minutes to go until halftime. The screen, the kick out, the three-pointer. Nothing but air, and Jamie Mitchell corrals the rebound. Thomas found a little wind in the stadium here.
They're going to come out on Juan Reyna now. There ain't no way. They're not going to let him catch the basketball.
Now you run him off screens, and that'll free up the rest of your game. He's been the threat. Let's see what the Hornets can make of that. There he comes off the screen. Not strong enough on it. 8 on the shot clock for Alabama State. Strawbridge will try one. Left it short. And Hart comes away with the rebound. Advance pass. Last touched by the Braves. Alabama State basketball.
Tell you what, pretty even in the rebounding. 15-14 Alcorn State. Alcorn State turnover 6-6. It's just all about shooting percentage right now.
Hornets shooting 5 of 20, good for 25%. That's not going to win you any ball games. Jackson to Strawbridge. Good ball movement by the Hornets. They've really keyed in on Juan Reyna. Strawbridge putting it on the ground, working in the post. Jackson to Mitchell. Mitchell for three, drills it. Alabama State cooking from downtown now.
If they're going to overplay Reyna, you know that there's going to be another guy open outside on the perimeter, and that's what Alabama State's taking advantage of.
I believe an offensive foul.
On the floor, foul.
It is on Walker.
Number 22.
No, they give it on 22.
Substitution into the
that's
game
going to be on Hart.
E.J. Clark.
E.J. Clark checks back into the ball game. He'll be the inbounder for Alabama State. The 5 on the floor for Alcorn State. Henry back on the floor with Joshua, Thomas, King, and Walker. Trying to run the Hornets off the screens. 16 on the shot clock. Barber being hounded. Hornets haven't gotten much going on offense. They just give it to Strawbridge and let him cook. Strawbridge turning. Clark, the three-pointer, way off the mark, doesn't draw iron. It's a shot clock violation.
DJ
and
goes
DJ
down.
Jackson took a shot by Hart. He was contesting the layup after the shot clock violation. Nothing malicious, just took a blow there.
They need to look at that. Yeah, they're going to look at it. They're going to look at it. And that's a smart thing to do. They're going to look at this foul.
Officials going to make sure that the ball did or did not hit the rim.
Well, they can look at that, and they can look at the foul.
I think that's also what they're going
to
get.
Yeah, they can look at two. They can look and see if it hit the rim, and then they can look at the foul, see if it was flagrant.
They're going to look at the follow-through that got DJ Jackson in the face. It was down for a little second, just took a tough little hit there. 2:05 remaining in the first half. We'll let the officials handle their review, and we'll take a short intermission. Stay with us, folks. Welcome back, folks. So following the official review by the officials, there will be two free throws assessed to Alabama State following the foul after the shot where DJ Jackson took a shot to the face.
Shooting for the Hornets, number four.
Yeah, it was a lane, it was a shot clock violation. DJ Jackson did not know that. He tried to go up, thought the ball hit the rim. He's doing what he's doing.
First basket is good.
AJ Clark getting that first free throw to go. He's 1 of 4 from the field, just the three-pointer to his name. Also has a steal as well. However, he is playing with two fouls, so that's something to make note of should Alabama State close the gap.
One shot.
23-19, the score with 2:05 to go. And Clark works on both free throws. Alcorn State.
10-2 run for the Hornets right now. They scratch back to make it 23-20.
1 point advantage, one possession game for Alcorn State. Alabama State possession as well.
If you remember, number 22 who screamed at us at the before the game started.
Oh, yeah, he had the big energy coming into the ball game.
He was a little hyped, a little over the top, and that's cost him.
Joshua hounding DJ Jackson. Very aggressive play, had it stripped from him. And Hart comes away with the steal. Henry had a mismatch in size. Floater inside the paint is good. Thomas gets that one to fall.
And Alcorn State defense was just really getting after it. Handsy.
Very physical.
Yep, very ferocious and physical.
Jackson probing. O'Neal. 16-footer. No good. Offensive rebound. Kenny Strawbridge, and he's tripped. Got the pass off. Jackson in trouble. Has it blocked inside. Probably should have kicked that one out and reset. Coming up on a minute remaining here. Justin Thomas will control the rock. They try to get it inside. That ball deflected.
Nice job by Jordan O'Neal. Nice little tip right off of Waddell Henry.
Alabama State wants to talk things over. Less than a minute to go until halftime. Alabama State facing a 5-point deficit. We'll be right back. It's the Hornets Sports Network.
Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, for more information on Alabama State University Athletics, be sure to follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. Search Bama State Sports for all your up-to-the-minute information on Hornet Athletics. Also, visit BamaStateSports.com, the official athletics website of the Alabama State University.
Welcome back, folks. Following the Alabama State timeout, 5-point deficit for the Hornets. The five to close out this half. Clark, Jackson, Mitchell, Strawbridge, and O'Neal. Sixteen on the clock. Hornets mainly passing around the perimeter, but they've got to get some action going here. 7 on the clock. EJ Clark might have to create something here. The crossover.
Thank you.
The foul and 2 free throws coming.
Foul on the shot. Foul.
Good job by EJ.
2 shots.
He got 3 points. He'll have 2 shots right now.
The point of emphasis for Alcorn State has been collapse inside. Don't make anything easy fall for us. Because if you notice, anytime anybody penetrates inside, as you see that free throw rim out, all 5 players on the court collapse. They make it so that the ball has nowhere to go and somebody's going to get a piece of it, and it's evidence by the score that it's working.
We need to get our live stats updated here. It's been stuck on 23-18 for a while, and it's 25-21.
forced turnover by Alcorn State. It'll go back to Alabama State possession.
Number five, Juan Reyna.
Oh, yeah.
The game for the Braves.
Shooting assassin.
Team. 15 seconds on the clock to make something happen for Alabama State. They should hold for the last possession. They could go into the locker room with a one-point possession. Clark, a little fast. O'Neal volleyballed it off the backboard. 3 seconds remaining. King passes it, and they don't get the shot off in time. It will not count. The shot swished through, but Joshua will walk away. And the Braves will walk away with a four-point lead. Folks, we'll take a halftime break and return with more action from the Don Oliver Acadome. Stay tuned. This is the Hornets Sports Network. Welcome back, folks. Still a halftime here, about 3 minutes left until we get things cranked up to start the second half. Alabama State currently trailing by 4 points at halftime, the leading scorer for all players to this point, Linnell Henry. He hasn't missed from the field in 3 attempts. He's 3 of 3 with 1 3-pointer to his name, also has 2 rebounds, 2 assists, and a block to his name. But that block is signifying something bigger that plagues Alabama State. It's the offense and their tenacious defense. Daryl, they're everywhere this evening. They have been closing and collapsing in on the paint anytime Alabama State has found a lane to drive into, and they've ran into a very stifling defense to this point.
One of the best defenses I've seen in a couple years here at the Dunn-Oliver Acadome. They are tenacious. They get after you. They are absolutely up on you, give you no free rein. It's amazing that Reyna has gotten open for 5 open jumpers. He's hit 3 of them, missed 2. But other than that, you really have to create your own shot. Alabama State's had to force shots because they just don't leave you open. And they hound the ball. They're ball hawks. They get after it all the way up the floor. And they rebound the basketball. They don't give you very many offensive rebound looks.
Alabama State in that first half shot a paltry 23%, 6 of 26. Alcorn State, on the other hand, shooting a hair better at 41%, 9 of 22. Alabama State, however, red hot from deep, one of those rare games when everybody can hit from outside if you give them a good look. They're 5 of 9, good for 56%, and that's not something you'd see too often from this Alabama State offense. They don't like to live from the outside shot. They want to get inside where they're more proficient.
And if you look at the points in the paint, man, that tells a story. 4 points in the paint for Alcorn, 2 for Alabama State. When have we ever seen that kind of stat line at halftime between two teams?
However, looking at the positives for Alabama State, they fared a lot better on defense to close that first half. Alcorn State was scoreless in the last 2 minutes of play, and it gave Alabama State a chance to go into the locker room with a 1-possession game. That being said, as we read the line, thing is up back here. It's a fresh slate, and there's still room to take the lead here.
There is, and you've got to just do a little better job shooting the basketball. I mean, we talked about the defense. It's a lot of what Alcorn's doing to Alabama State as to why they're only shooting 23%. It's the Brave defense.
The defense really hounded Joe Liddell and DJ Jackson. DJ Jackson, 0 for 4, scoreless to this point. He has 2 assists, but Gerald Liddell, this team's leading scorer, he only has 1 point off of a free throw, 0 for 5 to start this ball game. It's the second half here, and let's see what Alabama State talked about in the locker room.
Got to get O'Neal going, too.
Shot clock didn't start, so I think they're going to reset it.
Reset it, yep.
Keontae Montgomery to inbound.
All right, now we got to set it to 20. Keontae Montgomery is really ready to go here, and he's had to stop a couple times, and here we go.
Same starting five that we began the game with. It was the same starting five that gave Alabama State fits. They only had 5 points to begin the game, and on the first possession, a turnaround jumper leads to a couple free throws for Henry.
Yeah, Henry forced that shot, got bailed out by the foul call. He'll now go to the line for 2 shots, the leading scorer for the Braves.
Good on the first attempt. These are actually his first free throws of the evening. Not too many attempts from the free throw line in this one. That's just the 5th one for Alcorn State. Alabama State has had 6 attempts. So even though it's been a very physical game overall, there haven't been too many trips to the free throw line.
Officials are letting them play. Some token pressure now by the Braves. See if E.J. Clark can beat that. He does.
Alcorn State playing man. 12 on the shot clock for Alabama State. Strawbridge hands it off to O'Neal, top of the key. DJ Jackson still looking for his first field goal. Leaves it short on that one. Hart with the rebound. Hands it off to Thomas. Thomas to the corner, and he traveled. No, they'll say he stepped out of bounds.
Out of bounds on the play. Possession Hornets.
Those unforced turnovers, if you're a coach, absolutely kills you.
Byron Joshua's going to get called for that turnover. His second. I beg your pardon, it's just his first. Joshua is scoreless to this point. Just one attempt from the field. It was a three-pointer. Has a couple assists to his name. Waddell. Just the 1 point in this ball game. He hasn't been too aggressive since early in that first half. Finds his shot here. This time he drills it. Finally on the board with his first field goal.
Nice little fadeaway splash jumper. Big shot there. Cuts it to 27-23.
Just a four-point ball game. Alabama State still in this. The lead for Alcorn State was as large as 12 points. They kick it out. Three-point on the way. That'll be a foul. The closeout ran into the leg of Henry, and O'Neill is going to get called for that one.
Foul on the shot. Foul charge.
He kicked his leg out. That's what Coach Mo Williams is saying. He scissor kicked.
Williams pleading his case.
And that's a three-shot foul for Linnell Henry.
That's O'Neill's second foul of the ball game. That'll put Henry in double figures on the evening. He's the only player in double figures.
Two shots. Second basket is good. Substitution is in the game for the Braves, number 11.
Barber set to check in now.
Into the game for the Hornets, number 10, Michael Barber.
O'Neill will take a seat.
One shot.
Williams giving some words of encouragement to O'Neill. Oof, tough collision there. Dell took a hard fall.
Kind of went into the
stanchion there, yeah.
I mean, Linnell Henry missed the free throw. Oh, they're going to look at it again.
They're going to review this one.
Yep.
Official review.
Going to look to see if that's a flagrant on Walker.
He went after him pretty hard, but all he was trying to do was get his own rebound and dunk. It just, he hit him from behind.
Probably just a dangerous over the back, if most. We'll have the results of that review in just a second. We'll be right back, folks. Officials rule it a common foul, just an over the back. Or at least that's what one of the officials are trying to confirm here. That's what he's leaning towards. I'm trying to make a little eye contact or see if I can get some attention. No, they're not going to give me any. So ruling should be common foul if that was any judgment from what I've seen from that conversation.
So common foul, but that foul does go to Henry. That'll be his first.
Alabama State possession.
Possession
Alcorn State playing with more pressure. Clark.
They have not given Henry that foul either on the board or on our stats, and they need to do that. But maybe they have it in the book. That's the important thing.
Blocking call against Alcorn State. That one will go on DeKedron Thorne, seeing playing time for the first time this evening, 6'4 junior out of Houston, Texas. LaBelle can't get that one to fall. Possession will remain Alabama State. Loose ball foul.
Okay, so that's Henry's second. But he's only going to be showing one. It should be his second.
Adele backing down, facing the double team. He'll find Clark at the top of the key. 6 on the shot clock. Liddell may have to create something instead. They give it to Strawbridge. Strawbridge going to work, getting inside. Gets it off in time. Bailey draws iron. And the Braves come away with it. Walker with the rebound. They go inside. Double team comes. Walker with the finish. The recipient of that pass. Good pump fake, count the basket, and one. Gerald Liddell at the line for one more.
With the opportunity to make it an and one play. Foul charge of the Braves, number 0.
Okay, that's his third. That's his third foul.
Substitution into the game for the Braves, number 44.
They got him with 2.
Shooting for the Hornets, number 3, Gerald Liddell. One shot.
And I believe it's 4 personal fouls.
Liddell trying to find his rhythm on offense. Can't complete the 3-point play. He's 2 of 8 from the field. Just the 1 3-pointer attempt. Henry, the dish. Agnew can't get the finish, but he's fouled on the way up. He'll be at the line to shoot, too. Michael Barber will get called for that foul.
Foul on the shot. Foul charge to Alabama State, number 10, Mike Barber. 2 shots. Shooting free throws for the Braves, number 44, Darius Agnew.
Agnew's already had a trip to the line where he went 2 for 2. Those are his only points of the game. He does lead this team in rebounds tonight with 5 at this point. Rebounding margin slightly in favor of Alcorn State, 22-17 the margin. Alabama State limiting the turnovers just a bit. They've got 7 to this point. 1 for 2 at the line. Liddell with the rebound, and Hornets come the other way. DJ Jackson still scoreless, looking for his first field goal. Kenny Strawbridge will try a 3-pointer. 2 strong, 1 and done on the offensive end. The steal by Strawbridge, and he gets it right back and puts it in.
Good job not to powder salt after the missed 3 and still get after it.
Dale off his feet, but they go back inside to Agnew. Good ball movement by the Braves. 3-pointer hangs on the rim and finally falls in.
Kind rim roll there.
Good shooter's touch as well. Strawbridge working with 12. Barber the screen. Strawbridge. You see how they collapse inside? They nearly force the turnover, but they get it back. 5 on the shot clock for Strawbridge. Liddell's going to try a 3-pointer straight away. Airballed it. Media timeout incoming. We'll take one with you. With 15:50 to go in this ball game. Stay with us.
We're focused on student success. Choose from 16 undergraduate and graduate
Welcome back, folks. Coming out of the media timeout, it's an 8-point advantage for Alcorn State. Their largest lead had been 12 back when the score was 21-9 early in the first half. Since then, Alabama State has found a semblance of an offense. The shooting percentage still poor as the double team comes. That's a backcourt violation. They've been first forcing turnovers on the Braves. That'll be the 12th. The five on the floor right now for Alabama State. Juan Reyna is joined by E.J. Clark, Jamie Mitchell, Gerald Liddell, and Jordan O'Neill. The five on the floor for Alcorn State. Linnell Henry, Thomas, Walker, Agnew, and Joshua. Thomas defending Clark. Clark probing, waiting for the off-ball action. Six on the clock, the kick out. Jamie Mitchell for three, no good. Ball batted around, last touched by the Braves. The Hornets will get a second crack at it.
Alabama State now starting to get out rebounded the margins, plus six for Alcorn, and Reynard with a nice ball fake, wide open three. Oh, in and out. Oh, I thought that was going down, Daquan.
Reyna can't get the three-pointer to fall. Offense the other way. The one-man fast break. The layup is good. But Byron Joshua, his first field goal of the game. Just his second attempt. O'Neill hands it off to Clark. Clark, the good move. O'Neill, one dribble. The reverse, no touch. But the second is there. Gerald Liddell with the tip-in.
Liddell getting more active here in the second half. That's his seventh point. But still, Jordan O'Neill yet to scratch.
Pass to the corner. Three-pointer. Swirled in. Walker, another three-pointer.
Three or four for Otis Walker. And that's the difference in the game right now. Four of seven. Well, actually, overall free throw shoot or field goal percentage is under 27. Reyna
straight to the basket. He goes, and he gets the layup to fall.
He's got 11 to lead all Hornets.
14 minutes to go in this ball game. Strawbridge checked back in following his quick breather. Henry will try a three-pointer. He'll drill it. 3.3. It's a man that can play inside-out basketball.
14 points. And he does scissor kick when he shoots the three.
Yeah, notice kind of spread his leg there. Good move by E.J. Clark. Lost the handle a little bit. He'll get inside, lost his footing. Foul called. Byron Joshua not happy about it.
On the floor, foul in charge of the Braves, number two. Substitution into the game for the Hornets, number 20, Kenny Strawbridge. Into the game for the Braves, number 10.
Liddell will take a break. DJ Jackson also checking back in.
DJ Jackson. Also into the game for the Braves, number one.
McWhorter also checking back in. Strawbridge getting inside, headed, batted down. Long pass to Walker. Walker will reset with Thomas at the helm. Alcorn State back up to 12. The Euro, the kick out. Juan Reyna batted it back. They'll reset with 8 on the shot clock. The screen by McWhorter, and the steal almost there. Shot clock violation pending. Walker throws it up, and it got blocked.
Great job by Alabama State getting all over the floor, hustling. 12:58, still plenty of time remaining in this basketball game.
What a block by Darius Agnew on Kenny Strawbridge, too.
He just grabbed it. He almost pinned it.
Jackson. Kicks it out. Reyna looking. Finds Strawbridge on the wing. 15 on the shot clock for Alabama State. facing a 12-point deficit here. Got to make some headway here. The hesitation, the kick out, Reyna. Jackson, one dribble, the pull-up, left it well short. Thomas coming the other way, one man to beat, the pass. Agnew couldn't handle the basketball. Turnover, Braves. Checking back in for the Braves, the Kedron Thorne.
Substitution into the game for the Braves, number 24.
Also checking in for the first time, Mike.
Also into the game for the Braves, Piaggio. Number 2, Byron Joshua.
Really emptying his bench is Coach Landon Bussey.
Second year head coach for Alcorn State. Was an assistant coach for the Prairie View Panthers for quite a while. Good feed inside, and Jordan O'Neill finally gets his first basket of the evening.
And it's a emphatic one. It's a dunk. Now Alabama State cut that lead to 10. He's got some work to do, and he's got to start on the defensive end.
Timeout call. 10-point advantage for Alcorn State. Mo Williams rallying the boys, try to make one final run in the second half of the second half. We'll be right back, folks. It's the Hornet Sports Network. Welcome back, folks. It's the Hornet Sports Network. Daquan Lee here with Dela Dapprich. 10-point advantage for Alcorn State as the Hornets want to make it 2 wins in a row in the second game of a 2-game homestand here. Approaching the halfway mark of the second half as a probe inside leads to a kick out. Good closeout by the Hornets, and Liddell holding their man in check. Walker kicks it back. Long three-pointer, banks it in. King getting that one to fall from way downtown. Paul King.
That's demoralizing when you're doing everything you can from a defensive standpoint.
Jamie Mitchell thought Jordan O'Neill was going to cut inside. He saw him kind of holding him back, and he's just like, whoa, what? So, unforced error for the Hornets, and we'll take another media timeout. We'll be right back after a short break.
COVID-19 has changed how we stomp the yard and field goal. Now it's time to take the first step that lets us get back to strolling instead of scrolling. Before we can safely come together, we need the facts. As COVID-19 vaccines become available, you may have questions.
Is it safe?
Should I get it?
Is it free? It's okay to have questions. Now get the facts about COVID-19 vaccines at getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision for yourself and for your family.
I'm
Welcome back, everybody. 11:10 to go in this ball game, and Alabama State is trying to claw their way in and make some headway against this 13-point deficit. Last basket made was that Paul King three-pointer to bail out the Braves out of a bad possession. Thomas on the baseline. Had to back it up. A lot of traffic inside. McWhorter came to set the screen. King, he has Agnew under the post. Agnew was calling for it. The screen comes. Five on the shot clock. The crossover. Mitchell got his hand in there. Well contested shot, but man, that one just rattles in there. King.
Paul King again on a bailout shot.
Kenny Strawbridge just strolls to the rim. Nobody paying attention to the back line and just gets the easiest dunk of his life.
Very uncontested.
Might have been the easiest basket he's had all evening. Justin Thomas hands it off to King. King has it taken away by Kenny Strawbridge. His second steal, the Euro, and the finish. What a move and what a finish.
Strawbridge up to eight.
Great instincts on the steal as well to force that turnover. Hornets back within single digits. I missed both. They're still down 11 here. I'm getting a little ahead of myself.
Almost another steal by Strawbridge here. Oh, that's a foul, but they don't call it. Liddell all over. Now
that's a reach in on Liddell. Stuck his hand in the cookie jar one too many times.
Really could have got it up here right in front of us, Daquan, but they did not.
Keontae Montgomery checking in. Remember, this is a guy that's coming off a 27-point performance. He's 2 of 7. Montgomery is. He's only attempted 2 3-pointers. Agnew hands it off. The pirouette move, the spin. Montgomery kicks it out. Agnew. With O'Neal on him, putting the move on. Spins. Touch too strong. Liddell comes away with a board. Hornets come back the other way. Jackson with the move. The flip. Good ball movement. Mitchell behind the back. Has it taken away clean by Montgomery. One man to beat. Finishes the layup.
2 points.
That'll give him 7 on the night. 3 of 8 shooting.
Hate the turnovers where you try to go behind your back.
That shot denied inside, and both players take a tumble. On the fast break, Liddell, well contested, but the basket's still good by Keontae Montgomery. He's finding his touch right now.
2 baskets in a row gives him 9 points, and they're very acrobatic.
Another steal, but DJ Jackson staying in the play. Got it right back, going straight to the basket, draws the foul, and he'll be at the line to shoot two.
DJ Jackson came back in on the backside, did a good job of getting that steal.
Foul now he'll go to the Braves, number 44.
With his
shots.
Attempt to get his first
shooting
points
shooting free throw for the Hornets, number 1, DJ Jackson.
Unfortunately, Jackson not the strongest free throw shooter amongst all the players.
First basket is good. 1 shot.
I don't want to say anything yet. I think I gave him a little bit of a boost.
There
I did.
Go.
Okay. So now that he made both free throws, I can say he came into the game shooting 64% from the line. I'm a heavy believer in the commentator's curse. 52-39, your score coming up on 8 minutes to go. Window slowly creeping shut on that Alabama State to make a run here. Those back-to-back turnovers almost hurt him. The screen by Agnew. Good poke away by Strawbridge. 3 on the shot clock. The force up. The heave. No good, but an offensive rebound and a foul.
Yeah, he pushed McWhorter out of bounds, did Jordan O'Neal. Nope, they got, yeah. They got it on Jordan.
Media timeout.
Another media timeout coming. 7:57 to go here, 52-39, your score. coming out of the media timeout. There was a foul on Gerald Liddell. It'll be Braves basketball. Less than 8 minutes to go here in the ball game. Braves still on top, 52-39. This is a Braves basketball team that averages about 66 points per game. They shoot 30% from deep, as you see the steal here by Alabama State. Good fast break opportunity. Got two men on the ground. Can't get the basket to fall, and we'll have some free throws coming for almost, Gerald Liddell.
Yeah, almost a little unwell. DJ Jackson pleading for the intentional. Keandre Montgomery has some words. And now Liddell will shoot two. Will shoot two.
Foul charge for the Braves, number one. Two shots. Shooting free throws for the Hornets, number three, Gerald Liddell.
Dontrell McQuarter will pick up the foul on that one. Liddell credited for that first steal, the steal that got him to the line.
First basket is good.
Liddell starting to find himself in the second half here. He was really, really quiet and didn't have much going for himself. Now being active and injecting himself into the game.
Liddell converts both free throws.
Thomas hands it off to Montgomery. King.
Ooh, looks like a little bit of a carry there.
Got Mitchell on him. Probing. 10 on the shot clock. A lot of dribbling here for Paul King. He's calling for the screen. McQuarter. The pull-up is good. He's feeling it right now. He's in a rhythm. Paul King, give him 11 for that one. 4 of 6 from the field and a three-pointer, a heave to beat the shot clock. Strawbridge. Foul called. It'll be on the floor. Kenny Strawbridge doing a little bit of everything for Alabama State right now. He's got 8 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and 3 steals.
Now he'll be shooting a 1-1.
1-1. Shooting for the Hornets, number 20, Kenny Strawbridge.
Largest lead had been 15. Free throw no good, but he stays with it. Gets his own miss. Tries to reverse it. And the tap up is in. Gerald Liddell right there to clean it up.
Now in double figures is Liddell with 11. And Alabama State down 11. Got to do something to check Paul King. He's really hurt Alabama State. He comes in the game. He's only played 14 minutes. He's got 11 points.
Clark defending. A bunch of screens. Clark stays on him. They try to get the switch. King, the pump fake. One dribble pull up. Can't get the three to fall. Possession will go to Alabama State. Foul called on McQuarter.
And you like that because with 6:15, Alabama State can score on the clock stop. When you're trying to get back in, you're trying to scratch back in the game, down double digits. If you can score 2 points with the clock not running, that helps.
Just need to make your free throws. Liddell, 3 for 5 at the line. Officials want to talk something over. They're coming over to the review board here. Kind of want to know what they're looking at here. Both teams go to the huddles and get some pointers from their head coach. Alabama State shooting way better than they did in the first half. In the second half, they're shooting 43%. That's passable. 9 for 21, but in that first half, they only shot 23%. So a big step up and a big change for the offense that they had run prior to. But the issue right now, Alcorn State is shooting 80% on three-pointers, 4 or 5 in the second half, and that's been what's killing your offense. Also, these missed free throws are starting to hurt.
Yeah, they are starting to hurt. Right now, Alabama State, 8 of 13 from the free throw line, have yet to hit a three-pointer in the second half as well.
So the hot hand from the first half has not carried on over. Juan Reyna had three of those three-pointers. Thomas, defended by Liddell. Montgomery, the three-pointer, drills it. He's got a nice shot to him.
3 points.
He's got 12. Opens up that lead to 14.
Ball poked away by Paul King. Man, he's had a really effective second half. Forces a turnover on DJ Jackson. These turnovers are starting to sink Alabama State's ship. Justin Thomas. Burning clock. 7 on the shot clock. We go inside. Shot well contested and a good miss. McWhorter couldn't get that one to fall. Well defended as well. Strawbridge probing. The step through. Can't get the layup to fall. One and done. No. Oh, my goodness. Oh, no. That was completely unintentional.
It really was.
He was fighting for the rebound and trying to take it away to prevent the jump ball. And Strawbridge just took a blow to the face. That was unfortunate. You really hate to see that. That was just an effort play, and he just happened to be on the wrong end of it. Of course, it can get contentious at any moment, but, man. Strawbridge was still down. He took a really hard blow.
And one of the things you got to watch now, too, is the emotion, crowds getting after it. What you said, Daquan, is exactly right. He grabbed the basketball and was just trying to rip the basketball away. When that happens, there's a natural motion with your arms
swinging. With your elbow swinging.
With your elbow swinging.
He just so happened to take a shot there. Strawbridge is still down.
Officials will look at this.
It was Dontrell McWhorter that threw the bow.
Strawbridge still down. I think part of the reason that Strawbridge is still down is the contact of his head hitting the floor.
Officials obviously reviewing this. They want to get this one right. But I think just by letter of the law, they may have to give it a flagrant just for the action, even though there was no malintent behind it. And Jamie Mitchell came off the bench, so more than likely he's going to be ejected. He didn't check himself, and you can't leave the bench when there's any sort of altercation, so more than likely Jamie Mitchell will be done for the evening.
Yeah, they got to check out Strawbridge close. Concussion protocol type thing. His head hit the floor. He stayed down for a while. And now the other thing, too, just to be quite honest with you, Alabama State's got the police and the security officers got a job to do with a little bit of crowd control.
Kenny Strawbridge is back up and moving, obviously being checked on by the training staff.
You've still got 5 minutes left to go in this basketball game.
Yeah, so still a lot of time.
Still a lot of time. You got to be careful with, you know, the emotions down the stretch with that. You just keep everything in check right now. Coach Williams, the Alabama State coaching staff did a great job of keeping everybody controlled, under control, and cooled down there. Because it got kind of heated as they gathered around after it happened. There was some bumping then at that point.
Officials coming out from the replay center to get one final review and discuss it amongst each other.
I wish we could read lips.
And he just started covering his mouth because I was trying to read his lips.
Because I was looking at him. He was slick. Get the mic out there a little bit.
Last time he picked it up because it was quiet in here while they were reviewing it. But, of course, now the energy is all picked up. Crowd coming alive off the energy. Jeering all the Alcorn State players.
There's two fans at the bottom that are Alcorn State fans that are really egging on the crowd, the Alabama State crowd. And they're taunting and saying things, pointing at the score. It just needs to get under control. So still some conversation at the scorer's table as to what's going on here.
Officials coming over.
I'll get it for
number
you.
11 from Alabama State has been ejected from the game. Number 1 from Alcorn has been ejected from the game with a clear time.
So what we got is Jamie Mitchell, as you expected, he's ejected for coming off the bench. Number 1, Dontrell McCoy, he's ejected for a flagrant 2.
As I expected, it was really unintentional, but the action that led to it, just you can't excuse it. And Juan Rainer misses the first free throw attempt.
And Mitchell coming off the bench, he can't do that. That's why he's gone.
Just a lack of discipline on his part, so.
Rainer looked shook. He missed both free throws. That hurts when you're down 14. You got to capitalize on that. He didn't take his time. He got up and shot him quickly. Should be Alabama State basketball.
I think I would have preferred E.J. Clark getting those free throws at that point in juncture in the game. He's 3 or 4 to that point. Those were Rainer's first attempts from the line. Missed them both. Alabama State now in the double bonus. 5 minutes to go here. Could be a foul fest.
Possession Hornets.
So Strawbridge is more than likely done for the evening.
Yeah, well, you want to keep him in concussion protocol just to make sure.
I agree. Ball batted out of bounds off the inbound. It'll remain Hornet basketball. Strawbridge will be done. He's played 30 minutes. Didn't have a great night shooting from the field. 4 of 12. Finished with 8 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists, excuse me, and 4 steals. So a little bit of everything for him. Clark in the corner. O'Neal with the screen. They get the switch and the foul going against Paul King. That'll put Jordan O'Neal at the line to shoot 2.
His second.
2 shots.
Michael Barber set to check back in.
First basket is good. Substitution is in the game for the Hornets, number 10, Matt Barber. Into the game for the Braves, number 44, Darius Atwood. One shot.
It's just O'Neal's third point of the ball game, one of four from the field. Misses the second attempt. Hornets double King. King in trouble. He gets it out of the hands and into the hands of Thomas. Another foul. That one will go on Jordan O'Neal.
Hornets number two, Jordan O'Neal. Possession Braves.
Paul King to inbound. Coming up at the 4:30 mark of this ball game. Still a 13-point deficit for Alabama State. The largest deficit had been 15. Time's starting to dwindle here. Got to force some turnovers and get some defensive stops. Five on the shot clock. Braves are bleeding clock. Thomas is going to pull it. Draws iron, so the shot clock will reset. Great box out by Jordan O'Neal. Clark gets it to Michael Barber. Barber kicks it to the corner. Jackson probing. Has his shot blocked by Thomas, and the Braves gather the rebound. Thomas once again getting inside. Doesn't get the layup. Oh, no, it does fall. Caught that and one.
Left-handed finger roll that time by Justin Thomas as he crashes into the stanchion underneath the basket. But as it is, he'll have an opportunity to shoot the and one and extend this lead.
Media timeout.
Timeout on the floor when we come back. And one opportunity coming for Thomas. We'll be right back. It's the Hornets Voice Network. The score, 59-44. At the line, the shoot one, Justin Thomas. He's got his fourth point off that drive and score and an and-one opportunity. Alcorn State, 5-1 run. He completes a three-point play.
Braves convert the three-point play.
And the lead is extended to 15. Matches the largest lead of the evening. The defense has really gotten away from Alabama State because they're allowing a shooting percentage of the second half of 70%. As you see the fight for the loose ball, jump ball call. Possession, Alabama State.
Jump ball possession, Hornets.
Alabama State still fighting, scratching, clawing, down 16 here with 3:43 remaining. Shooting has been the tale of this game. The story, 54%. for Alcorn State, 62% Daquan from behind the arc. So that's tough to overcome when you get those kind of shooting percentages.
Sweet shot by Gerald Liddell. He's got 13 points. More than likely, the Braves are going to burn as much shot clock as they can before they get into their sets. It's crunch time now. The floater doesn't go. Liddell with the rebound. Hornets got to go fast here. Juan Reyna on the floor for spacing purposes. Liddell kicks it out. DJ Jackson, the corner three. He drills it.
Three-pointer! DJ Jackson for three.
And now you've got to get steals in the backcourt. 2:53 down 11. Still don't have to foul here. You can still play defense all the way up to the shot clock.
Henry, the screen. Illegal screen.
Foul. Yep, there you go. And that'll be Henry's third personal foul. And that's what you need, a foul like that. Stops the clock.
Possession Hornets.
See if Reyna can get free off a screen here.
Paul's on Clark. Paul has given Alcorn State plenty of good buckets here. That's a bad steal. And the finish inside. Ball got wedged in. Montgomery couldn't finish it. It'll be a jump ball possession, Alcorn State.
Substitutions in the game for the Braves, number 44.
Darius Agnew checking in. Henry gives it back to Thomas. Coming up on 2 minutes here. Agnew the screen. Montgomery will try a three-pointer. Too strong off the back iron. DJ Jackson with a board. Jackson pushing it. The floater doesn't get it to fall. Tipped up. Offensive rebound, Jordan O'Neal. And he's fouled in the process with the free throws coming his way.
Alabama State going to the glass hard now. That's their 11th offensive rebound. That's pretty amazing. Now they're getting out rebounded 34 to 30. But they've got 11 offensive rebounds.
Quick 5-0 burst for Alabama State. Jordan O'Neal at the line trying to reduce this deficit.
First basket is good.
See if we can get it to single digits for the first time in a long time, Daquan.
One shot.
Two for two with the line.
O'Neal converts both free throws.
Two minutes left. 9-point game. A stop here is crucial for Alabama State. Agnew. The kick out. Paul King, all the time in the world. It's down.
He's the dagger guy. That's 14 for him off the bench.
Liddell, the kick out. DJ Jackson dishes it. O'Neal, he's going to finish that. Count that, and one.
Wow, that's a way to get a three-point play. Conventional after Alcorn hits the three. But you come back and get it with the clock stop.
Basket will count. Opportunity for a three-point play. One shot.
O'Neal up to seven now on the night. Opportunity.
Shooting one for the Hornets. Number two, Jordan O'Neal. Substitution is in the game for the Braves. Number two.
Alcorn State downsizing. Darius Agnew checks out. Three-point play is good. Marvin Joshua checks in for Alcorn State. Timeout on the floor. We'll be right back. Crunch time here at the Dunn Oliver Academy. Stay tuned. Welcome back, folks. Off the inbound, Hornets need to force a turnover here. Reyna slips, 20 on the shot clock. Foul called. That one will go on E.J. Clark.
And it will be a 1-1.
1-1. First basket is good.
King with 15. He's really played strong off the bench. Actually now leads Alcorn in scoring.
Tied with scoring at the moment with 14, unless he makes his free throw, and he does not. So he's tied in scoring with Linnell Henry. E.J. Clark putting the speed on, gets to the rim. Oh! Baskets will not count. That putback will not count. There'll be a foul. No. I don't know what they called. I didn't see it.
I think they said count the basket.
Now another foul called.
I mean, I think they did. No?
No.
Foul charge
for
Alabama State.
No, you're right.
1-1.
Actually, no. I think they're calling goaltending on it because they did give him credit for the basket on live stats.
Okay.
So the layup, the layup does count. They give him credit for that, and Juan Reyna immediately fouls right after. Justin Thomas at the line for a 1-1. Good on the first.
First basket is good.
Two for two at the stripe. That bumps this lead back up to double digits. 1 minute remaining. Got to come away with every point possible. Foul called. E.J. Clark will be at the line and shoot two.
Foul charge for the Braves, number two. Two shots. Shooting free throws for the Hornets, number four, E.J. Clark.
.57, what you're hoping for is some two for one.
Two shots.
Or hit a couple threes and have them split their free throws.
At this point, you can't come away empty on any possession from this point. If you do, the game is over. 30 seconds on the shot clock. They can bleed it down to the last 5 seconds. You're left with, give or take, 35 seconds. They're using up all the 1-1 fouls here, hoping for a miss. A smart play overall.
The problem is Alcorn's been shooting lights out at the free throw line tonight.
They have.
81%, 13 of 16.
The 9 of 12 in the second half from the free throw line. They're 6 of 9 from deep.
First basket is
in the second half. 9 of 15 overall. So 60% shooting from three-point land, that's going to kill any team. Both free throws good. Time dwindling down. This is more than likely the final attempt. Clark for three. Rims out. Loose ball foul. It'll go on Alcorn State. An Alcorn State player still down, however. Had a tough fall.
Linnell Henry is who's down.
Officials getting ready to do another review. Ten-point advantage, 44 seconds left in this ball game. I think the writing is on the wall.
Yeah, you got to get a possession there. You got to. I mean, if Clark hits that three, you still have life. You still have a heartbeat or a pulse if he hits that three. It goes in and out. We're going to see what the officials are going to say here as far as what kind of foul that was. Still talking it over. 44.6 remaining.
That was Henry's fourth foul. A moot point nonetheless, but in case things get interesting, it's something to make note of. You can take one more look at it.
Finally looks like they've made a decision. All right. Well, here we got. I'll check it for you, Quan. All right, so we got a flagrant foul, one, on Linnell Henry, a hook and hold foul. You get two shots and the basketball.
So this may be the break that Alabama State needs.
Now that's his fourth foul, Henry's. So this is gives you a little bit of life right here.
You knock down these free throws, 8-point game, you get the possession back.
You hit a three, you got a 5-point possession.
So now that fourth foul could make things a lot more interesting here. Of course, Mo Williams will take a timeout here to talk things over now that he sees new light in this ballgame. We'll step aside for just a moment. Welcome back, folks. 44 seconds left in this ball game. Alabama State has new life following that flagrant one foul on Linnell Henry. Time is bleeding, though. Alabama State needs a three-pointer. They run Reyna off the screen, but it's all for naught. Offensive foul on the screen. That one will go on Jordan O'Neal. Ran Byron Joshua right into that screen, and that'll just about seal the deal.
For that possession right there, that would have been huge to cut that to 68-65. But
5-second difference between shot clock and game clock, but the writing is on the wall. Alabama State will drop this one here at home. Their second game at home in conference play. They'll have about 5 days to talk things over, look over film, and see where things went wrong. What went wrong in the second half, however, was the shooting, especially from deep. 1 of 6 from three-point land. Getting to the rim, and the layup is good. Justin Thomas now in double figures. E.J. Clark will fire one last three-pointer, and that will do it. Alcorn State best Alabama State here at home. Your final score, 70-60. Your leading scorer for Alabama State, Gerald Liddell, he came alive a little bit in the second half. He finished with 13 points, 5 of 12 from the field. Went 3 of 6 from the line, 8 rebounds to his name, and throwing a couple assists for his efforts for Alcorn State. Paul King, he was the man, the king, if you will, in the second half. He finished, led all scorers with 15 points, 5 of 8 from the field, 2 3-pointers, and did just about everything for Alcorn State and the Braves in that second half. He was electric. He got everything he wanted and really made Alabama State pay.
Yeah, and the bottom line right now is just the shooting percentages. Alcorn State at 52%, shot 60% from three-point land. Alabama State struggled at 34%, 38%, which is not a bad percentage from behind three-point land. But that was just too much to overcome right now. And you look at the free throws, 16 of 24 for Alabama State, 15 of 18. I mean, Alcorn did a great job shooting free throws. They out-rebounded Alabama State. Alabama State did win the turnover battle. They were a plus 6. So all in all, the stat line doesn't lie. Alcorn State shot it and shot it well, and that's why they won this game by double digits.
Alabama State will have a little bit of time to gather themselves before they take on their rivals in the Bulldogs, Alabama A&M. They'll be in town to take on Alabama State. That game will be January 15th. We'll hope to see you all there. Until next time, Daquan Lee, Daryl Dapridge, signing out from the Dunn Oliver Acadome.